So I like to complete now our section on time discretization of stochastic processes. So we had here this large section on time discretization of stochastic processes. And I just want to add that remark, Monte Carlo simulation of time discrete stochastic processes. I believe I made this several times, just a few slides now. So we have now our Euler scheme, which provides us here with a time discrete stochastic process, and we have the Monte Carlo method. And you see that in each time step, I have here an independent increment from the Brownian motion. So in each time step, I have a random variable, and for every TI, the random variables are independent. So if I like to do now Monte Carlo, this time discrete stochastic process is actually a high dimensional, a multi-dimensional random vector that is the domain of the integration of the Monte Carlo integration method. Yeah? So each time increment here is one component of my vector. So if you like to do a Monte Carlo simulation, of course, you just sample now random path. So I sample events omega j. You just plug in the omega j in this equation. So all the guys are random variables, x and w. And now you have an equation on each Monte Carlo path. So the connection now between the time discretization of the stochastic processes and our Monte Carlo method is quite obvious. The only thing that you have to be aware is that this guy here is, in the context of the Monte Carlo integration, a component of the integration domain. Yeah? So one coordinate of the integration domain. So we have a very high dimensional integration. So if you have n time steps, we have n dimensions. Okay, so then if you like to approximate the expectation, we just use the Monte Carlo approximation, take the sum over all sample paths, and you see one omega is now the sampling of individual random variables. So this here is a Monte Carlo integration in 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 dimensions, yeah? Because we have 5 time steps. Weighted Monte Carlo translates exactly the same way. Yeah? So we have a weight, yeah, in front of the guys, but this weight is now the probability that this path here occurs. Yeah? So it is a weight in the 5-dimensional space. Finally, to complete here this remark, yeah, you also see this if you take a look at the implementation of the Brownian motion in the code. So let's go back to the code again. So we had here this nice example for the Brownian bridge. And look at the implementation of the Brownian motion. So if you look at the implementation of the Brownian motion, you see that I generate here a normal distributed random number using a uniform distributed one and using the inverse of the distribution function. Okay, then I do this for every factor of the Brownian motion, and I do this for every time step. So this inner part here is actually the remark that we had at the very beginning of the Monte Carlo method. Maybe I can find this. So this remark, how we generate a vector valued random variable, or a sampling of vector valued random variable from a one-dimensional sequence. Okay, we do this by just populating all the elements, element by element. And this is what is happening here in this inner part. I'm actually filling this high-dimensional vector from this one-dimensional sequence. And when I have done that, I have completed one omega, one sample pass. Okay, so you have to be aware of this. And so this is also the order in which I do this, because maybe the uniform random number generator has a guarantee to be uniform in a certain dimension. So that should be the order how I do it. I first populate the full vector, then I move to the next sample pass. I also have an implementation for Brownian motion that uses a given random number generator. Okay, and here in this implementation, it is even more explicit that I like to do it in that way. Okay, so there is a random number generator given here. And this random number generator, so if you just have a look at it, so this random number generator immediately provides a random vector. Recall, for quasi-random number generators, we cannot generate a high-dimensional vector from a one-dimensional sequence. For a quasi-random number generator, we have to explicitly specify the dimension. Yeah? Think of the Horton sequence. Yeah? It's wrong to generate a two-dimensional Horton sequence from a one-dimensional Horton sequence. It's wrong. So we have to specify a high-dimensional random number generator here, and it will get you here immediately the next vector. Yeah, so this is a vector. So if you then go to the code where this random number generator here is used, you see that for every sample pass, I'm requesting this vector, and then I'm populating the Brownian increment using the vector according to this rule. Okay, so I iterate through all factors. So if it is a high dimensional or multiple dimensional Brownian motion, Brownian increment, and then I iterate through all time steps. So here it is even explicit that the dimension of the random number generator has to match the product of dimension of Brownian motion multiplied with number of time steps. So that was a small remark on Monte Carlo simulation of time discrete stochastic process. And that was it for this session.